What's up, and citizens, welcome back to Redemption 46 Studios. Make sure y'all do me a big favor and hit that subscribe button. If y'all aren't subscribed, y'all are crazy. This is the best reaction channel on the planet. Decided I wanted to give you guys the NCT Killing voice. This was our first reaction to it, so you guys can enjoy this. If you guys want our newest reaction with some people who also didn't get an opportunity to see it, go jump on the Patreon. As far as NCT goes, we're going to have some exclusive stuff on there. Also going to be doing some YouTube exclusive content for people who can't get on the Patreon. We love you guys. NCT has been killing it. The Doja Young stuff is crazy. The behind the scenes stuff for that is dope. We're about to start jumping back into the uncuts. Let's get it, man. We love y'all. Thank you for all the support. Enjoy the video. What's up, and citizens? Welcome back to Redemption 46 Studios. I'm Nick.
Anyong, Jayon, Yumira.
And I'm Zach.
You know the vibe. You look real dapper.
No, I'm just threw some shit
got
on.
Got your Philly shit on, right, too. Yeah. Shout out, yo. Damn, you should have told us.
I threw the hat on because I'm woofing. And then, yeah. You know.
Nah, but you could have wore that. He probably would have wore some Sixers shot through the Eagle shit on. And it would have been like a trifecta and shit.
Nigga, I'll wear this shit again this week.
Yeah, okay. Maybe one day this week.
Like the Redeemer's going to judge me? Matter of fact, yo, let's wear this shit on Saturday.
Y'all know the vibes. Y'all seen the thumbnail. Y'all seen the picture. Y'all know why y'all here. NCT 127 Killing voice. Wild thing is, I feel like we talked this into existence. Besides the fact that we, every time we do a killing voice, we said that they'd be perfect on this joint. Mm-hmm. No long talk. I kind of already know what we about to get into and shit like that.
It's just the hits.
I wish I didn't kind of see some of the titles.
I wish they all was in Hangul, even though I know some of the names in Hangul. Like, I see Kick It right there.
Yeah, it's already cheating. I see Favorite right there as well. Cherry Bomb. Touch is God tier. Well, at least I thought
touch,
it was
touch change like
that change.
Oh walk, yeah, what was it? Walking the
I thought it was Fly Me Away. Was the
yeah
last
yeah
one
Fly Me Away
was the last one we did too.
127 man, I told you they the
no yeah no long talk. I feel like they gonna fuck. I feel like this might be our best one. No, let's jump into it. Sorry, Keith, the trouble stuff.
Sorry, Jared.
Yeah, say no. I told both of them we'd be doing this.
Oh, okay.
Gougers.
Yeah, okay. Some real niggas.
Big John. Jungwoo, Utah.
Some real ones in the building.
Some real niggas.
I left the one.
Jayani.
Shit, Jayani. Johnny looked real dapper right there, too.
Let's go. My boy's always got some fly shit on, man. They the flyest, man. Oh, it's not in order? Okay, cool then.
Yeah. Yeah, let me introduce to some new things. Bass kick swinging like a Bruce Lee. Bruce Lee. Shimmy, 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 body boom, body boom, body boom.
Shout out to all the Redeemers that hit me up.
What up, Jackie?
Coming up, chicken yogurt. Hands high.
Tony!
let's go. Yeah, got the drip, bringing them to go. Eat it, bone and gum. All these fools will make it pop. Keep them moving like you're crawling. And I'm from Argentina, Samuel Jackson, Bill, what's up? There's it going on, baby. You just gotta watch. Put the dirt in the new girl, that's it. Go to go, he might just match it up. Looking at everybody, looking at me. Cam, fix your mommy, shit.
Fire truck.
All you bound, Mr. Farmer of the flow. But the G-Pro by your gator, shake out your kill. But my nigga got a chunk with the walk and a gear. Just staring through the air, again and again. I'm
supposed to go line. Hey, she's gonna want to get a no.
You should have snatched your girl up. Come on, man. With it, what? The fire truck.
Gotcha.
Someone said we didn't do Limitless video. Yeah, I remember doing it.
He had the curly hair.
Yeah.
He's like, why you got that brace? This chorus is everything.
Get away. It's like singing together. I didn't know this many beautiful voices could speak at once.
Baby, I don't want nobody but you. Get your G-A-G.
Don't talk.
All the guys are shooting the sounds. You want time? Kind of
hey.
No net, okay. Booming a drum, shit, it's not a name. Taking a gun, shit, it's a reach in the back of my head. Harder than all I fed, so one go pick it. Keep watching the now, don't get about it.
Hater, hey, talk. Who you talking about, Mark? Who does ain't that, Mark?
Watch every bomb, dude. Come on.
Woohoo!
Hey, 여러분 역사 잘 보셨나요?
네,
네, 사실 저희 127이 아주 딩고의 진심인 그룹이거든요. 그래서 지금부터는 저희 NCT 127 자체 투표를 통과해서 완성된 저희 127만의 사랑하는 수록곡 들려드리도록 하겠습니다. 마크는 오늘 기억할 건가요?
난 기억해.
Say it. Oh. 누구나 지금 바로 Baby touch me.
Something for like fresh air. I know, right? They like
baby.
Hey, let's go. Na 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 na.
Let's go.
Yeah, do we
I believe that.
Yeah.
Yeah, English version.
Okay.
Girl, you know that I need you in my life. So chill, Johnny. He said, come here real quick. I need to talk to you.
You'll always be my favorite.
Come on, man. What y'all gonna do?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, here it is.
You need it. You sound like so.
Come on, man. Yo, what we doing today?
Come on, man. What you gonna do with them? Back to you. I got both these off the album. I got Moody's to my K playlist.
Yeah, I add everything there first. Automatically
added. Got y'all 127. Y'all on my K playlist for those B sides. Oh, this album fire. I don't know why I don't have Limitless on there. I'm not holding back. It's like, hey! This is just a B-side. Like this need an NDI refeature.
Yeah,
bad bad.
Yeah, love is fun. I'm a smile for why who gon' stop me now? Hey, 마음의 목소리를 자르는 건 작은 걸음이지만큼 변화야. 지레 겁먹지 말기, 모두 불완전한 이 탓하지 말기. 행복한 상상을 매일 하기. 제일 중요한 건 네 자신을 믿기. Oh, what's this?
Welcome to my playground from the Regulate album. This sound right up Hayton Alley.
They about to gang bang this beat.
Welcome to my playground.
It sound like I know they had some nice suits on when they did live. They probably was in there like this. I like that little piano on the back there.
I'm sorry, this is getting downloaded.
I
think I'm in
love with you. I am.
Now remember, you heard it. You heard it. Voice. This ain't me cheating.
Those other songs don't stick on the. That piano in the back is just crazy.
Rhodes keys, man. Like.
Why does it sound like. They about to draw.
Nah, you gotta chill, though, y'all.
Bring us home, though, y'all.
Yo,
come
yo,
on.
Yo.
It's another joint off the new album. They just giving us
two baddies.
Yeah, because the End Citizens, we might be doing a review.
I'm about to say, how much tape they giving up, bro?
Shout out to Redeemers, too. It's like the song was originally called Two Bitches, One Porch. Two Bitches, One Porch.
A little misogyny.
Yeah.
Two baddies, one porch.
Redeemers, see my name is here for it.
No, that's what I'm saying. Misogyny sprinkled in here.
He said respectfully.
One of a kind, pocket but now I'm licking my eyes.
Like, hey, are they performing this whole time? Okay, Johnny.
Let's get away right now to buy the game.
Jump on. Get on the most here, remind you of
me. Zero to back on the highest beat. Can't get up and move the opti.
You should have some chicks in the video.
Come on, Jay.
Baby, what's your style? Check out on the camera now. Wow, that'll be the one song. Check out my heart, what you thinking on? What? And now you wanna ride these wheels? Through the ghetto town, no, the one I guess you
feel.
Yeah, we got no time to chill. Pick you me, body, body, pop, I ill.
Utah.
Are you doing this whole thing?
Yeah,
it all makes sense. Promotion.
When you thought you had a little dance, you start feeling that shit. Jay on Tom. Fuck him up.
앞으로도 사랑하고 다음에 또 만나요.
감사합니다. 사랑해. Zip, dude, look, the booth over. They still want some more. Y'all could have gave us a few more.
Listen, man, y'all, I like the energy.
Could have threw in a few more in there. I don't like to hear a good thing in the minute. I feel you though.
I like it.
I liked it.
Or focus.
Mm-hmm. Damn, I feel like I was at church. This was a good joint, man. Even like I said, with them, even songs that like may not particularly be like your favorite and shit like that, it's just their energy, their talent, and just them kind of get you in the mood to just even be on par with the song and just kind of fuck with that song's energy.
I want
to
say we downloaded like 2 or 3 songs.
Yeah, I was surprised. They play every B-side that I love off of the Limitless joint and shit like that. Yeah, some shit in here. It's some shit that we still got to react to.
It is some joints. They left the Magic Carpet Ride. They left that one off. Like it, I said, Focus. It's a couple in the what was it? Fly With Me.
Yeah, I feel like I didn't even look at the track songs. I felt like they left like some track songs off there too and shit like that.
I figured they was gonna perform like Two Baddies because you know they want to promote the new joint and everything like that.
I guess they didn't do Sticker and all that stuff too.
I thought they did Sticker.
I don't think they did
Sticker.
Yeah. Did they?
They did. I thought they did Sticker. Wow, I'm tripping.
Nah, I think they did Lemonade and all that.
No, they did Fire Truck.
Fire Truck debut joint.
Yeah, because it would have if they did it, it would have been right. Yeah, Fire Truck was the joint they did, and I didn't. Limitless.
And then, like I said, they did Lemonade, and then they did the other joint. But I didn't. At least, like I said, I didn't hear him play Sticker.
No, they didn't. They didn't because it would have been up. It was Fire Truck that I was thinking because I didn't like Fire Truck. Remember when we reacted to it? That is crazy, man. I actually thought they would have did the. I guess they were saving their voice because I'm surprised they did Kick It so early. And like some, I'm surprised they did Kick It early. Some of the other ones, I thought they would have kind of went in order, because I think that's what we seen Simon do, and we seen some other people do that, like go in order and everything, like chronological order or whatever. But I mean, 127, man, regardless, it was still a hell of a showcase for their songs and everything like that. Like I said, they left a lot off the table. There's only so much time you could do. They could really have went like 45 minutes with this if they wanted to.
Regular is another joint.
Oh, regular. Gimme.
Simon Says.
Yeah.
They could have super, Superhuman.
And Lay.
Shut Up and Dance. Like I said, Superhuman they didn't do. Punch they didn't do. They did How Would Have Him. We said we didn't react to the English version of that. Like you said, Gimme, Lemonade. Yeah, other than that, they did a couple of joints and shit like that. But like I said, I'm glad they did it that way, though, to kind of put us on some stuff that we didn't hear and then to introduce us to some of the other stuff that's on the new album.
Right.
Album review will be coming at some point when everything clears up.
That designer song is a banger.
I like that over that's Two Baggers.
I do, too.
I like that over
Two Baggers. No, that's already my favorite song off
that,
the
album. That's so far my favorite song off the album. And I ain't hear anything yet, so I don't want going too biased and shit. But I like that a lot. If they doing another MV and shit, you know, not to close out the year because it's only September.
Right.
But like if they doing another MV, please.
The intro. Yeah, they got it because this is a full album. It's 12 songs.
It's 12 songs.
43 minutes. So you know today's time, that's long. So pause. But yeah, man, this is.
I like this. I like this really a lot. I like how it was 22 minutes. I understand how you said like
this was 22 minutes long.
Mm-hmm. 22 minutes long. Right. That's it. They could have gave like us it. So much more. That's what I'm saying. They could have went for 45, bro.
And you feel like it was 22 minutes. But it felt good. I like how this is. I feel like this is something you can play like in the background while you're getting dressed, or like a pregame to turn up before something.
Hell yeah.
It was definitely a vibe. I loved all the songs, but there's a couple that I really, really loved. It was like Touch.
Yeah.
Designer, definitely. Like you said. I think Highway to Heaven. Mm-hmm. Was that right after Touch?
I think so. Let me see. And like I said, y'all getting Highway to Heaven, the English version soon, too.
I like that a lot. And another thing that I really loved about this is how they transitioned each song. That was fire. Even though they didn't play some of like the whole songs, it was like, ooh, we know where to cut. We're going to cut right here to lead into the next song. And that was really clean and fire.
Yeah, you know what I love about 127, too? I always say, like, just NCT in general is, like, my comfort K-pop group.
Mm-hmm.
If there was a group that I wanted to show, like, I guess my black friends, quote-unquote, NCT to me would be, like, an easy segue, I feel like, because especially if you pick certain tracks.
R&B joints are hit automatically.
That would translate there. And that's something we're going to have, like, coming up on the show, too. I know we talked about it at the show. Jesus Christ. What we talked about before, too, for us to pick songs that we would play for somebody to, if you were introducing a K-pop song to your friends that don't listen, what song would it be? So I'm pretty sure a lot of NCT tracks are going to be on there. Back to what I was saying. I call them like my comfort group because it's such an easy transition for you being like, damn, is this really K-pop? Like, this kind of feel like R&B.
I feel like if I made an idol R&B song, they would be at least 33% of an idol R&B playlist.
I get what you mean.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Like, they are groups sometimes. Sometimes it sounds like I'm listening to, like, Boyz II Men or like, you know, 112, Jodeci. Mm-hmm. Some of these shit sound like Babyface.
The harmonies almost, like, are the perfectly harmonies. Arranged and everything like that. Like,
but somehow they can go from that to, like, the Migos, mm-hmm. if they feel like it.
And or like some like bad boy punk funk, like fun.
Mm-hmm.
That switch up.
Yeah, like I don't even want to call it like Rocket Power, like they kids or something, but you know, like
I know
the headbands and goggles and like, yeah, like that type of shit. Like they can take it different places.
Just that stuff. Cool look, like a cool like 2000s look.
Like I said, you know how like K-pop has a couple stigmas, like as far as it being like kind of like super digital and like robotic or whatever like that, which once you listen like we have, you definitely disagree with that. And then the whole are like they're pretty boys and, you know, all of that kind of shit. I think 127 goes completely against that stigma, even though you will have like videos like Favorite where they're very made up and, you know, the mullets are like colorful and leather pants and all that shit like that. I feel like if I was showing a young boy this, and was like, bro, nah, this group go hard. They're crazy. Like I said, obviously, like, Monster X would be one of the groups, too. But NCT 127 kind of embodies all that without, not like us saying, like, other groups' masculinity is not there or something like that. But, like, I'm like, here, these dudes are just, they cool. That's what it is.
Yeah,
the cool is there without them being like super soft and
they walk, you know, that gentle. Fine line, like you said, where sometimes they like might have like they'll have makeup on and like we said, makeup is makeup.
This, yeah, yeah. Black, and then, like I said, this is not this is not my opinion to downplay them or to downplay people who wear makeup or are softer in appearance. But I'm saying if somebody was like, give me a if I'm talking to a traditional person who wanted like a tough boy band or like a cool, like just cool. I think that's what it is. Or I should have led with that, just saying that.
I know what cool. I think it helped you out.
Yeah.
Strike one caught you by surprise.
That type of energy. Yeah.
That energy. Imagine that and compare it to Let's Play Ball.
Because we like, and that's like, what it is. You know, we like, I mean? Bow Wow.
And we like Bow Wow.
I made that Mark time. Comparison before. Like, he kind of reminded me of like how Bow Wow was like being younger and everything. Just mm-hmm. the attitude and swagger. That's what it is. Cause Boyz was rapping some of Bow Wow stuff. Like when he first came out, I was rapping "Would It Be to the Old Dub."
I don't think not just some. I think a lot. I think people were dressing like I said. He's one of the people.
He made the braids.
He's a punching bag now, but like in his heyday and shit. Like he was cool. Like you know how many people was dicky in them Tracy McGrady jerseys. You know what Jones I'm talking about. When Take Me Home came out and shit like that. So deaf. The basketball joint when Bow Wow had like his renaissance and shit with the braids going down and shit like that with the headbands and the forces with the spray paint.
Bow Wow and Omarion pioneered like the braids. Like obviously Snoop was there, but like Bow Wow and Omarion really put it in the high gear for like
especially when generation. Niggas was doing the individuals and shit.
Yeah, the individuals
and shit like
the,
that.
And like because
it looked cool.
It went from just being like, all right, just like some your braids and fuzzy or whatever to like really like some pretty boy like. Sprayed down and like you care about your braids. You wear the durag over your braids, like your braids is fresh all the time, type of thing like that. So
and for comeback and for comebacks, Bow Wow had like a lot of looks. He had times where his hair was just out.
Yeah, it's really really nice to meet
you. When he did you know, that's my shit. When he did the Omarion John, remember those other Jones was twisties beads, with the beads and stuff. Mm-hmm. So we do this a lot off camera. I don't like sometimes we do light comparisons, but we do like a whole bunch of. We literally talk about comebacks and eras now for like Western.
We use K-pop terminology.
We use K-pop terminology now outside of reactions, which is beautiful.
But just segueing, what I was saying was that their NCT is the cool K-pop group that I feel like is ubiquitous and can show to everybody. Like I said, there's nothing wrong with groups being soft because they have those songs where they get soft and gentle and everything. And I like it regardless. I'm just saying as far as like, say if I'm an executive producer and I'm like, we need the label wants or the owner of the label wants a cool group. He wants a cool group. Okay, we'll push these guys. We'll bring these guys here because they can do that, do this, do that, do this, you know. They kind of cover all the boxes and everything like that. And like I said, the soul is there vocally and everything. So,
Zach, anything else from there?
Yeah, other than I'm cool because I can rant about like 127 for days. I'm pretty sure Lil' Ken too.
Yeah.
They're just the epitome to me of cool. Their talent, I think, collectively, they have some of the best talent just in the K world and in the world in general. I don't think they have a weak link in their chain. I think their weakest member, if you want to start casting stones to think about who, and I say that in the sense of like obviously like vocal arrangements, line distribution, screen time, whoever you think that member is, to me is probably cooler than some other niggas leader of their group,
or probably will hold his own, or doing everything else with some other groups.
Yeah, they're not a slight, like no one in the group just like lacks talent or isn't a visual or can't dance or do anything, and I find that decent because collectively like you can get attacked on all fronts. Even hearing shit, I know we have like our vocal bias and everything like that all on here, but they collectively were carrying that energy throughout the entire line whenever anybody wanted to jump on shit. And some of their harmonization, just where they're such a unit and a team, it feels like they all know when to get in and when to fit in. We're like, yo, I know I can falsetto, but this low time to get his falsetto off.
It's Nick time to go and do that, hit that note and everything. Or no, Zach about to come Zach up with the smooth part. Everything, it plays out well how they do that, especially now, like they doing solo material, like with the labs and everything. That Jay Young song's been stuck in my fucking head, bro.
That shit been on repeat,
put a few people on too. That shit been on repeat, bro.
That might be my favorite solo joke. Because Tae Young at first overtook me with Ghost as the kind of best solo.
If it's not available for download, I can't really. Let me see if it's.
I literally just kind of had to play it. At least if you find it and it's down and you can download it, thank God. But I have to just YouTube it to play it, which sucks.
Yeah.
Jay Young shit, I can just hit fucking, that shit is on repeat and I'm cleaning and doing whatever and so on. Yeah, anything else you want to add? You gotta, you looking to see if it's downloadable?
I'm looking. Nah, it's not on here.
SM, what are y'all doing? Yo, you're holding back
good. Give us the damn song!
Let that shit out the vault.
Yeah.
Other than that, N Citizens, jump in here. Tell us what y'all favorite track that they did on here. Let us know where y'all ranked this at for y'all killing voices. Also, tell us how y'all feel about the album. An album review will be coming. So just be like a little bit patient. Other than that, and citizens, we love you guys. So definitely gonna holler at y'all. Peace.